Thank you again. Thank you for coming. And this again, as we all know, this is one of the very special moment and a special time and a special day for all of us, for all of us who are connected to receive the teachings of the profound teaching of the Buddha Shakyamuni from this great master. So many years we received, we bathed by the authentic teaching of the Buddha Shakyamuni. We showered by this great teachings, practice is observing our heart and mind. Truly, this is what we celebrate today. We remember of the old wisdom, all the wisdoms and the conclusions of the teaching of the Buddha and all the great masters that echo throughout the Himalaya mountains and the Tibetans and all the beyond the Tibet and continued came in here. And this great teacher brought such great teachings, authentic teaching of the Buddha Shakyamuni that used to practice in India and matured so many beings in the enlightened state according their practices. In the opening in the Buddhist history says, on the three liberation status, liberation state of the Arhata, liberation state of the Pratigya Buddha, and the liberation state of the Bodhisattva Yanas, their total enlightenment state, and then truly the Vajrayana states. Those authentic teaching that brought to this country is one of the beacon of the great Buddhist light that in this part of the world, he truly was. And he came, he left with beautiful, magnificently. Exactly what the teaching said, exactly what we learned. This great master did exactly that way. He came, he did, he left beautiful. He left a beautiful monument, legacy, that will be remembered through generations to generation to come. So today we're celebrating of his memories, but at the same time we're celebrating of our all the achievement that did, what we did throughout these last 3 years. And through the assistance of the many devoted Sangha members, the dedication of the Sangha members, truly we achieved so many marvelous things in this country and as well as out of this country. That representative of the, in the always in the Buddha teaching said, that representative body of the enlightened beings, that represent the speech of enlightened beings, that represent the wisdom mind of the enlightened beings, that represent of the qualification of the enlightened beings, that represent the activity of the enlightened beings. In that five contexts, I think we did quite good through again. Everyone joined together. As this great master used to say, lifting the carpet from four corners. We left the carpet from four corners, we did. Today we rejoice of all our deeds, the good things. Representative of the bodies of the enlightened activity, such a look this beautiful image, the representative of the all the lineage, very important lineage master, that which is curved, again dedicated Sangha members. Felix, many of you know, his marvelous skills and dedication and love to the Dharma and the lineage, and really he curved. Those are, I think, many of you maybe we know. There is a great master, Lupchi Sanji Yeshi Rinpoche. There is a great master, Patamba Sanji, who was the founder of the Shivji lineage, or the pacifying suffering, that pacified the suffering lineage. And then, as well as great Taksong Nompa. And right in front row, I believe, the first one is Jipsin Sengi Wamso. That we received this great teaching from these great masters 6-7 years ago, maybe about that time, in this marvelous, beautiful, inconceivable lotus land of the Vihara. In this beautiful place, we received those teachings, authentic teaching. And we observe and we preserve with our courage and commitment, devotion. Those are the light that so many enlightened purpose of British enlightenment. There's nothing really different at all. Is how we handle this. Those are the great teaching. Only is question how we handle with devotion, courage, and commitment, and joyful effort. And we have that enough. Those Chetri Sangha Vamsa, the Hindu lineage teaching, so many people reach enlightenment. And Chetri Sangha Vamsa himself become the transcendental Western Rainbow Body in the Buddhist history or the Nyingma Buddhist history. He is the one of the great master who achieved the transcendental Western Rainbow Body around the 11th century or the 10th centuries. He's one of the elite great masters. And the next one is, I think, Rongzhongpa, great master of Rongzhongpa. We again had a great opportunity to receive from this great teacher, the Khenchi Pathe Chirarambuj, who gave the so detailed teachings how to establish and bring out every phenomenon systems in the divine mandala, enlightened mandala. That is the great master. Always in the Nyingma Buddhist history said, great Rongzhongpa, great Longchenpa. This is the true, like as the sun and the moon, moon are like in the Buddhist history or the Nyingma Buddhist history, in the scholar, particularly also scholarly aspect of that. Of course, they are totally enlightened beings. In the realization aspect, there's so many great beings come one after another. But the scholarly aspect of these are two great teachers. So Rongzhongpa and as well as Longchenpa. So this is Rongzhongpa's image there. And then another one is, the next one is known as the Iron Bridge Buddha. Whenever you heard, he's one of the great, again, Mahasiddhas, great Tetum, great Master Kundral. Great Kundra mentioned about him. To begin to mention about him, he said, Nanguru Pema Sambhava came in the form through the womb. That means, according to his story, Nanguru Pema Sambhava miraculously appeared from the lotus, or middle of the lotus appeared. But the great Kundra said, Nanguru Pema Sambhava, who came through the womb, and that is known as Tangdongpa, Tangdong Japo. He is a union of the Nguru Pema Sambhava in the teaching, said, Haya Girva, together came as one single form, the Tangdong Japo, iron bridge, bridge border. And many Buddhists, again, I heard from the history, historically, he was among the first great men who built the iron bridge through the big rivers in the whole world. History. I heard, you can correct those things, but I heard that he is the one of the really first great iron bridge builder, that he built the iron bridge from the big rivers. In the Tibet, there's, you say, 108 iron bridge that he built, 108 iron bridge, and there's a few of them left. And his techniques are so unusual that that's who came, I think, in the 14th century, until now, those irons, they're still those who are, which are there, bridges, irons are not rusted. And many scientists are who think of how, what kind of technique he used. That's what we heard. And also he was one of the, in the world level, or kind of public service levels, as he said, he built the iron bridges, and as well as also, he is the first, I think, created Tibetan Dharma, those are known as the Lama. A big kind of organized when he created the Dharma. And in the teaching said, or life story said, that because there's so many poor paupers, beggars, and hunters, because particularly hunters that he liked to avoid that hunting. But same time, those paupers are poor. They're hunting not just for the pleasure, but they're hunting for their surviving purposes. So therefore, he created this Dharma known as Lama. And there's a few different Dharma, and they just started playing that. Through that, then they converted or they changed their profession into non-violence ways. So again, he was one of that. And then, particularly, of course, he revealed so many Therma teachings, great lineage holders. In the teaching said, he many times went around the world, and benefiting so many beings through his magic or the wisdom, enlightened powers, said. And so he was also a long life. Over 120, 110, 115, many people said that he stayed. And in the area, for example, everybody thought he was passed away. And right after that, somebody saw in a different other place. He's still walking, he's same way, going different places. So many people said that even though he showed at one place, he passed in some other areas, that he is still active. So he's just a death. Is kind of illusion. Death, of course, in the teaching, always say that. So this is the great Tangdongpa. And then as well as we are able to do beautiful statue, able to get beautiful statue of the Buddha Shakyamuni, marble statue of the Buddha Shakyamuni, about 6 feet in the Nandri site. And as well as, then also we are processed making the statue of the Khenchi Pathe Chirarambuj himself, and his own Dzogchen Rinpoche, and Yogi Pema Sotam, the Lama Jangcho. The statues were processed to make, and those are all representative of the body, the enlightened body aspects, a body of the enlightened activities. And the speech aspect of the enlightenment, and again, we able to, there's so many things, but again, in these last 3 years, we able to publish the English version about almost like over three, no, not seven volumes, seven books we able to publish it. No? Over seven books. Over seven books we able to publish it in honor and as representative of the Khenkhi Padishara Rinpoche and as well as his own Dunja Rinpoche and hidden yogi Lama Jangcho and as well as all the lineage masters. So that we able to publish it in the context of the Bodhicitta and the devotion. Hope this is not just become the monument in one time, but in the teaching said, it will continue to benefit for all the sentiments. As long as I always think, as long as the language of English existing, books are published in English, will continue to ignite and inspire and the deepening of the practice of the Buddha Dharma that. So we able to do that. And then represent of the speed, what's the mind of the enlightened beings, we are able to do this always in the stupas. So we are able to do so many stupas through your assistance. As you know, here is so many stupas surrounded in the memory of the Khenkhi Padishara Rinpoche, and as well as three beautiful stupas about over 5 feet, handcraft, best crafts means curved, three stupas, one in the karmic public areas, beautiful. I had the great opportunity to part of that and consecrate that last my trip, this last month. And as well as two beautiful stupas in Gochi Monastery and as well as Rochi Monastery. Those are accomplishment of the great wisdom mind of the enlightenment. And the quality and the activities, then we continue to maintain of the quality is the, always in the teachings that quality of the enlightened beings is true love, devotion, bodhicitta. And those are we trying to maintain ourselves as much as we able to do. With our courage and commitment, we did something quite good. We didn't decrease our devotion and joy and bodhicitta. Truly, with some degree, increases. So therefore, increasing and deepening, and those are the quality of the old enlightenment. Activities of the enlightenment beings, again, through their blessings, through their enlightenment activities, we continue to maintain the activities of all different activities that what we used to do. So this is all as offerings and to the old enlightened beings and to the, our great teacher, Khenkhi Padishara Rinpoche. And as well as we rejoice over all our deeds. That's what we did. So I'm so thankful, so grateful, all of you participating and able to come to this beautiful time and beautiful places. And thank you again. Thank you very much, everyone's participation and everyone's joy and devotion with this celebration. Thank you, thank you, and thank you. And now I'm going to say last to remembering, to re-strengthening our spirit up. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
That was loud and clear. Whether it's rainy or not, I think we usually do the practices in the evening.